Hello friends, how are you? I hope you all are good. Now in previous lecture, we saw whatever rules of inorganic IUPAC nomenclature of coordination compounds. Okay, so we will discuss here few examples. And before starting examples, whatever cationic part or anionic part we are going to discuss here, okay, what will happen when complex anion? Okay, so see here, we will make one chart before nomenclature of inorganic coordination compounds. Okay, for beta complex, yes, complex anion. Okay, now in that see, we will make a chart here, metal, okay, then cationic, and here what? Anionic. Understood? So what will happen when cationic part is there, how we have to write the name of that complex, and when anionic part is there, how we can write the name of that complex. Okay, so see here, suppose metal, your silver, okay, Ag. So whenever your cationic complex is there, cationic coordination complex is there, at that time you have to write simple as a silver for that complex. Okay, and whenever anionic complex is there, at that time you have to write what? Argentate. Okay, when your iron is there, okay, so say here, when your iron is there, Fe, at that time, whenever cationic complex is, at that time you have to write simply iron, and anionic you have to write what? Ferrate. Okay, when your copper is there, at that time for cationic you have to write a copper. Okay, and for anionic you have to write what? Cuprate. When Au, okay, Au is what here? Simply gold. Now these are what here? When anionic part or eight. Okay, understood? When Pb is what? Yes, lead. Okay, at that time your anionic name become changes with what? Plumbate. Understood? What will happen here when your complex anions are possible? At that time we have to use these names. Cationic for simple you have to write, and for anionic we have to use what? We have to add suffix ate. Understood? So we will say in detail regarding nomenclature. We will now say whatever different examples of inorganic coordination compounds. So suppose, say I am writing here as a first, okay, Cu NH3 4 2 plus, okay. Now here second, suppose I am writing here Ag NH3 2 plus, okay. Okay, now say Co En twice Cl2 and plus. Now we have to write inorganic IUPAC name of this complex. How we can write? Say, very much simple. Okay, and as you know, we have to write what? First cationic part, then anionic part name. Okay, now we saw in the rule also, first you have to write whatever ligand name, thereafter central metal atom, then we have to write whatever charge present in complex, we have to write in Roman numerals. Okay, so see here how we can write here. Now say CuNH3 4 2 plus, see their name as like this, you have to write with the small letters only.
Understood. So here ammonia and 4 ammonia are there. So as we saw in prior only, whenever ligands names we saw. Okay, so these are what, amine. So tetraamine. ठीक है, टेट्रामाइन कॉपर, ये सीयर, दीज आर वॉट कंप्लीट कैटायनिक पार्ट. अंडरस्टूड. सो देयर फोर वी आर राइटिंग हियर सिंपली कॉपर. नाउ ओनली वी सॉ. अंडरस्टूड. सो टेट्रामाइन कॉपर, नाउ वी हैव टू राइट वॉट ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर ऑफ दिस होल कॉम्प्लेक्स. अंडरस्टूड. सो सी CuNH3. सो NH3, any charge is there on NH3? No, there is zero charge. So complete whatever your oxidation number of your copper is what? Means 2. So see here, tetraamine copper, what will form here? Second ion. Understood? Tetraamine copper, second ion. Now see here, AgNH3 twice plus. Here what will happen? See, as you know, first you have to write with a ligand name. Now here how many are there? NH3 2. So here what? Diamine. Okay, diamine silver. Why silver? Because these are cationic part. Diamine silver. So how much charge? First ion. Understood? First ion. Like that it is very much what? Very much easy. Diamine silver first ion. I hope you understood this all. Now see, suppose if you are considering this third one example, and we are now writing what IUPAC nomenclature of this inorganic complex. Okay, so here ethylene diamine, EN is what? Ethylene diamine, and this CL is what? Chlorido. Okay, and here starting with E, here chlorido. See, so whenever more than two ligands, okay, whenever more than two ligands will form, we can call it as a what? Heteroleptic complexes. And these are what? Homoleptic complexes. Similar ligands are there, means homoleptic complexes, similar ligands. And whenever two different ligands are there, at that time we have to use term as a what? Heteroleptic complexes. Understood this? One more new term, that is homoleptic complexes and heteroleptic complexes. Understood? So see, okay, here two different ligands are there. One is start with E and another is start with C, that is chlorido. So alphabetically, which one will come first? Yes, A, B, C. So chlorido will come first. So how we can write? Yes, beta. Dichlorido. Okay, dichlorido. Now here this EN is what? Yes, EN is what? Your bidentate ligand. So for that we have to use base trace and tetra case. But here what? Two are there. So we have to use what? Bis. So dichlorido, bis, ethylene diamine. Okay, ethylene diamine, cobalt. Okay, so see here, I am writing here, you can write continue. Cobalt, dichlorido, bis, ethylene diamine, cobalt. So charge, see here, charge how much? Simple, say how we can determine charge on central metal atom. Okay, X plus, there is a charge on ethylene diamine, no? Okay, Cl on Cl2, so here minus 2, because 1 chlorine is minus 1, as you know, from 10 standard, okay, in 11 standard also we saw
basics of chemistry in that always chlorine how much charge minus 1 so here 2 are there so minus 2 is equal to what is plus 1 so therefore x is equal to what here plus 3 means here cobalt how much third so dichlorido base ethylene diamine third cobalt third iron means we wrote name of each and every ligand with how many these are number with oxidation number okay now our what this IUPAC nomenclature will complete of each and every complex understood we will discuss some few more examples also okay we will discuss a few examples now see here what will happen whenever we are going to discussing here few more examples regarding this so ready for that okay so see here suppose I will write here few more examples CO Cl okay H2O NH3 4 okay Cl2 now regarding this complex what will be the IUPAC nomenclature now you can also write easily okay so basically see here what will happen COCl means three different ligands are there okay these are starting with C aqua and these are what amine okay now alphabetically what will come yes A will come but here Q and here M so first what we have to take AM as a what amine okay so whenever we are writing complex you have to check this alphabetical order also of their naming of that ligands naming of ligands so see here what will happen here yes tetraamine okay tetraamine thereafter what aqua tetraamine aqua chlorido okay chlorido thereafter what cobalt chlorido cobalt now see here how much oxidation number of this cobalt here you can identify easily see very much easy to identify without being any calculation means x plus that x plus minus 1 here charge 0 here charge 0 plus this minus 2 okay understood so I will write here again x plus this Cl is what minus 1 no charge on this water and this ammonia therefore you can write as a 0 okay understood is equal to what is okay plus this minus 2 is equal to 0 therefore x is equal to what plus 3 understood when here any charge will come whatever charge present on this okay when is means is equal to jo palikade kadil jo tumcha complex hoti overall charge asil either plus 2 plus 3 at that time here only is equal to jo palikade tumcha je kai sign hai te yel okay otherwise whatever these also we have to belongs into this whole calculation keep in mind this okay so minus 1 and is minus 2 so x is equal to what plus 3 so cobalt what third cobalt third chloride here you don't write second chloride or dichloride
simply we have to write what? Chloride. Understood? So these small small things you have to keep in mind whenever we have to write coordination IUPAC nomenclature of coordination compound. These small small things. Otherwise what will happen? आपकी सारी मेहनत पानी में जाएगी. ओके, सो टेक केयर ऑफ दिस. सपोज इफ यू वी विल डिस्कस बेटा हियर अनदर कॉम्प्लेक्स. रेडी फॉर अनदर कॉम्प्लेक्स. आई होप यू आर राइटिंग, यू आर रिमूविंग नोट्स केयरफुली. ओके, यू हैव टू राइट नीटली, यू हैव टू राइट क्लीन. Okay, because same notes you are referring further, so you have to write clearly, neatly. Understood? So see, next we will discuss beta AgNH3 twice and Cl. Okay, see beta here, how we can write. Some student they can write easily, okay, because this year AgNH3 twice Cl. Understood? First name we have to with a ligand. So here what beta? Yes, one only ligand, then no issues. Diamine, diamine, there what? Thereafter silver, because it is a cationic part, and these are what? Anionic part. Okay, diamine silver. So x plus 0 minus 1 is equal to what will happen? Means x plus 0 plus this Cl is what? Minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore x is equal to what? Plus 1. Understood this? Okay, so diamine silver first. Okay, I hope you understood. First, thereafter what? You have to write of this chlorine also. First chloride. Okay, I hope you understood this. Okay, suppose if you will discuss here, I hope you wrote this all. If you will discuss another coordination complex. Okay, so see, ready, PtNH3BrCl H2O. okay, so see here beta, PtNH3BrCl H2O, these different ligands are there. Then we have to arrange alphabetically order of these ligands. So see here, this what? Starting with A, aqua. This what? C, chlorido. This what? Bromido, means B. Here what? Amine. What beta? Here amine. So here AM and here AQ. So what will come first? As you know, what will come first beta? Amine. So one only amine. So here what? A amine. Amine. Thereafter what? Aqua. Okay. Amine, aqua. After that what? Bromido, bromido. Thereafter what? Chlorido. Yes, chlorido. Then next what? Platinum. Platinum. And what is the oxidation number? Yes, you can find easily. Because here on Br also one minus charge, and on chlorine also one minus charge. Okay, and water and on ammonia there is no charge. These are what? Neutral ligands. So what will happen here?
अमाइन एक्वा ब्रोमिडो क्लोरिडो प्लैटिनम एंड हियर व्हाट यस सेकंड बिकॉज हियर वन माइनस ऑफ वी आर वन माइनस ऑफ क्लोरीन इज इक्वल टू जीरो देयरफॉर एक्स इज इक्वल टू व्हाट प्लस टू आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस थिंग ओके नाउ सपोज इफ यू विल डिस्कस हियर बेटा नेक्स्ट कॉम्प्लेक्स NiEn2 2 plus now see what will happen whenever we are writing the IUPAC nomenclature of this nickel En twice see here what En is what bidentate so as you know for bidentate what will be the condition we have to use prefix as two are there so for that bis okay so beta here bis ethylene diamine nickel cation is there nickel what yes second ion because there is no any charge on this ethylene diamine second ion because positive charge is there okay now we will discuss few more examples of inorganic IUPAC nomenclature of what coordination compounds okay see I hope and you are means you are cope up with this whatever our part is going on that is IUPAC nomenclature of coordination compounds so see here next one that we will discuss K2 yes K2 Zn OH4 K2ZnOH4 so see here whenever we are going to write for such type of complexes so see here you can observe here cationic part and these are what anionic part okay now see how your central metal atom changing their names we discussed prior only okay of this starting of this lecture only we discuss when cationic part is there present at that time how your central metal atom changes their name and only in anionic part how it changes cationic part it changes so say yeah now these are cationic parts so whenever cationic part is there so at that time you have to write cationic name first thereafter anion means it is our rule cationic part you have to write name of that first thereafter what anionic part so see K2 understood here K2 zinc OH is what our ligand okay so as you know what we have to name this hydroxo simply we are writing as a hydroxyl group but these are what our hydroxo in inorganic IUPAC nomenclature understood so see here K2 so first you have to write a name of this potassium okay so no need to write dipotassium don't do like this like a mistake means don't write dipotassium okay like that as you know there is a Cl2 out of that coordination sphere we not writing that time the dichloride trichloride we are writing simply as a what finally chloride like that here also we have to write what simply as a potassium madhe kiti asude 3 4 okay we have to write what? Simply potassium. So we will start. Potassium. Yes, thereafter ligand name potassium tetrahydroxo. Potassium tetrahydroxo. Now see how your the zinc is changing their name. Their suffix is what? AT. Potassium tetrahydroxo. Okay, tetrahydroxo. Zincate. What? Zincate. Zinc. Now these are anionic part. Therefore, what? Zincate. Potassium tetrahydroxo zincate. Yes, what? Second ion. What, beta? Second ion. Understood? Second ion. So see how oxidation number of this zinc is +2. So as you know, this +2, each potassium charge +1. So here how much? 2 are there potassium, therefore +2 plus x plus -4 is equal to 0. Therefore x is equal to what? Yes, +2. Understood? So like that, whenever cationic parts are there, we have to write the name in this fashion. Okay. So see, we will discuss one more example. Ready? Okay, so see, K4FeCN6. Whenever you are writing the IUPAC nomenclature of this coordination compound, cationic and anionic parts, so see here total K4 are there. So here what, beta? Yes, potassium first cation name, then what? Hexacyano potassium hexacyano. Okay, iron when cationic part, at that time your name of this center metal atom is what? Iron. But now these are what? Anionic part is plus and is anionic part. So therefore here what? Potassium hexacyano ferrate. What will happen? Second ion. Okay, so you can calculate the charge also, okay, of your iron. Now we will discuss, okay, these are how we discuss some simple complexes. Okay, means one is our cation, means simple cation, and this complex anion. Okay, somewhere we discuss what complex anion and then okay complex cation and complex anion. Okay, so here these are what we can say as a, you can write easily name of any inorganic IUPAC complex. Okay, inorganic IUPAC name. Okay, so see here, when what will happen when both are complex are present, complex cation, dono part jab complex honge, okay, then at that time how we can write, okay, how we can write the IUPAC nomenclature of that both the complexes. So see here, okay, see what will happen. I am writing here PtCl2NH34. Okay, and what, beta? Here PtCl4. Now here I think such type of one complex we discuss in previous video also. For such type of complex, so see here what will happen. Here one is cation and another is anion. But both are what? Complex ions. Cationic anion part. So here you must know common oxidation number of this central metal atom. Common oxidation number. If you know the common oxidation number, then you can easily write diupac nomenclature of such type of what? Complexes. Okay. So see here how we can write. See. So basically what will happen? For platinum, when you discuss our periodic classification of elements, okay, at that time you saw this platinum in D block, okay, in our transition series. So at that time you may observe the charges present on this platinum, okay. Most common oxidation number of this platinum is +2, okay. So whenever this cationic part and this anionic part, so how charges will distributed? +2 and -2. This is very much important part, means whatever this cationic anion part, you must know what? You must know the common oxidation number. Suppose example, as a copper, okay, so you may observe copper common oxidation number is what? +2. That never change. Okay. Now, as you know, beta, you are zinc also. Zinc common oxidation number is what? +2. Like that, common oxidation number at any cost you must know. Okay, and it will come automatically, like when we are doing practice. Okay, it will come automatically. Understood. So see here, we have to write a name of this. Okay, so pay attention how we can write the name of this. Say, first we have to write a name of cation, then anion. Our rule is there. Okay, cation and anionic part. Okay, so see here, cationic and anionic part. First we have to write cationic part name, then what? Tetramine. Yes, tetramine. Thereafter what? Dichlorido. Dichlorido. Okay. Here what? Simply this cationic part. Therefore what beta? Platinum. Platinum. Now here these two and these two. Okay. So x is equal to what? +4. Okay. So see here x plus -2 + 0 is equal to what? +2. Therefore x is equal to what? X is equal to what beta? +4. So therefore platinum here what? 4th. Means tetramine dichlorido platinum 4th. Therefore thereafter you have to write this name continuous manner, continuously only. Okay, so see, tetrachlorido, yes or no? Tetrachlorido. Now this PT as anionic part, therefore their name will change. Tetrachlorido what? Platinate. Okay, platinate. What will happen? Okay, second ion. Okay, understood. Okay. So here we saw how we can write the, when both complex ions are present. One is cation and another is what beta? Anion. Okay. I hope you understood this contain, ठीक है. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस आईयूपीएसी नेम, आईयूपीएसी नेम ऑफ सम ब्रिज कॉम्प्लेक्स कंपाउंड्स. व्हाट बेटा? आईयूपीएसी नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ से ब्रिज कॉम्प्लेक्स, ब्रिज कॉम्प्लेक्स कंपाउंड्स के आईयूपीएसी नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ ब्रिज कॉम्प्लेक्स कंपाउंड्स, ठीक है. वी विल राइट हियर नेम, वी विल राइट फर्स्ट स्ट्रक्चर बेटा. सी हाउ वी कैन राइट द स्ट्रक्चर. सी पे अटेंशन केयरफुली. ईएन ट्वाइस सी ओ एन एच ओ एच सी ओ ईएन ट्वाइस एंड वॉट बेटा हियर थ्री प्लस चार्ज. ओके सो सी हियर वॉट एवर दीज आर, सी वॉट एवर यूर दीज कॉम्प्लेक्सेस एन एच एंड एज ओ एच वी कैन राइट एज अ वॉट ब्रिज लिगैंड्स. What beta? Bridge ligands. Okay. And for that we have to use prefix mu. Mu as a, we have to use what? Prefix. This small thing you have to keep in mind. Suppose if we will compare here. Okay. Say here it is a case of odd and even. Okay, so for that, for comparative study of these complexes, I have to write another complex also like this. Say en twice co, we have to do comparison. Okay. And as you know, comparatively study is better. It is very much easy to memorize all that things from comparative study. So say here, one thing here you have to keep in mind, whenever plus 3 charge of this whole bridge complex, so at that time when odd, it is odd number and here what? Even. So at that time here charge how much on each center metal atom means plus 3. When there is a odd charge is present, and when even charge is present, at that time whatever center metal atom charge you have to distribute equally. Means here what beta? Plus 2 and here also plus 2. Understood? Okay. Now one more here important part is what? Okay. So as you know here nitrogen is more electronegative than cobalt, and here also oxygen is more electronegative. So in this case what will no any changes because here odd number, so we can distribute easily. Means there whatever common oxidation number of cobalt they will get here, but what will happen in even number when overall complex has a even charge, so what will happen at that time? At that time what will happen? So see, nitrogen one will pull electron and oxygen also will pull one electron. So with respect to this cobalt, here what will happen? Here you will get what? Plus half charge. Okay. And here also plus half charge.
ठीक है. व्हेन नाइट्रोजन विल पुल इलेक्ट्रॉन लाइक दैट ऑक्सीजन ऑल्सो दे विल पुल इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो देयर फोर हियर ऑल्सो प्लस अप एंड हियर ऑल्सो वॉट प्लस अप. अंडरस्टूड? बिकॉज नाइट्रोजन इज मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव दैन कोबाल्ट एंड ऑक्सीजन ऑल्सो मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव दैन कोबाल्ट. सो लाइक दैट हियर कंडीशन टोटल वन इलेक्ट्रॉन दे विल पुल हाफ फ्रॉम. ओके अंडरस्टूड? सो हियर टोटल चार्ज नाउ वी कैन कंसिडरिंग प्लस टू एंड इज प्लस हाफ एंड इज प्लस हाफ. हियर टोटल प्लस टू एंड इज प्लस हाफ टू टू टाइम्स. सो टोटल चार्ज बिकम्स हाउ मच प्लस थ्री एंड हियर ऑल्सो वॉट प्लस थ्री. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. दैट्स वाई वी स्टडी हियर कंपेरेटिवली when e odd charge and when even charge at that time what will happen. So we will do the naming of this. So basically naming of this bridge complexes we have to do from left to right. Yes, from left to right. Okay, so see the name of this. Okay, we will start naming of this bis. Sorry, because first letter is what our small only. Bis ethylene diamine. Bis ethylene diamine. Then what here? Cobalt. Yes, third. Bis ethylene diamine cobalt third. Thereafter what? Here NH is what? NH we can call it as a C. You have to keep in mind here. Okay. NH 2 minus we call it as a imido and NH 2 minus we call it as a what? Yes, amido. You have to keep in mind this imido and amido. Imido and amido, you have to keep in mind this. Understood? So see here. Here hydroxo H, here hydroxo H and here amido I. So which one ligand will come first? Yes, hydroxo alphabetically. Here also alphabetically. So we have to take care of these small things. It is very much important. Okay. So bis ethylene diamine cobalt third. Now see here, beta, what? Yes, I am writing here. You can write in continuous manner. Take a mu hydroxo mu hydroxo mu what? Amido cobalt third bis ethylene diamine. This ethylene diamine. I hope you understood this very much interesting part regarding bridge complex. Whenever we are doing naming of this bridge complex compounds. Okay. Understood? Now one more we will discuss here. Bridge complex compound. Okay. Bridge complex compound. So pay attention, beta. On this bridge complex compound. So see here, I am writing here. Okay. NH3 4 CO, NH2
एनो टू, ठीक है, हियर वॉट CO NH3 4, हियर वॉट बेटा NO3 4. नाउ दिस ब्रिज, वॉट बेटा दिस ब्रिज कॉम्प्लेक्स, यू हैव टू राइट नेम फॉर दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स. सो यू कैन ऑब्जर्व हियर NH3 4 CO. ओके, नाउ यू आर थिंकिंग देर इज नो एनी चार्ज गिवन लाइक दैट प्रीवियस. इन प्रीवियस दे गिव एज अ प्लस 3 एंड वी सॉ रिगार्डिंग कंपेरेटिव ऑल्सो वॉट प्लस 4. अंडरस्टूड? सी here what will happen, yes this NO3 4, so according to crisscross what will happen here, 4 plus and here what, 1. Understood? So here 4 plus charge will goes, so as you know even, so what plus 2 and plus 2 here will goes. Thereafter what will happen, yes as you know this nitrogen and this nitrogen also what, more electronegative than cobalt, so therefore it will pull electron and automatically what, automatically you will get charge on this, overall charge on that cobalt is how much, yes plus 3. I hope you understood this. So overall charge plus 3, overall charge you are also plus 3. Understood? Okay, so you can write now name of this. See, so first left to right, so see as like this, tetraamine cobalt third, then here what, mu amido, and here what, mu nitro cobalt, okay third, thereafter what, tetraamine, and last is what, nitrate, last is what here, nitrate. So these are what overall name of this bridge complex compound, bridge complex compound. Okay, so see here, like that we saw simple complex IUPAC nomenclature, then complex cation and anionic part nomenclature, then IUPAC nomenclature of bridge complex compounds. Okay, so now it's time, whenever they gave a nomenclature of any inorganic IUPAC okay complex, they will give a name, and from that name you have to draw coordination compound formula. Okay, ready with this? So you can write the formula of the following. You can write easily, see here how you can write in next part. Okay, what you have to write, write the formula of the following, write the formulae of the following. See, first we will discuss here, first they gave here diamine
डाइक्लोरिडो, प्लैटिनम, सेकेंड,
ठीक है,
सेकेंड गे पेंटामाइन, नाइट्रिटो ओ, कोबाल्ट, थर्ड आयन, ओके, एंड थर्ड दे गेव एज लाइक दिस, थर्ड दे गेव सोडियम, ओके, सोडियम टेट्रा एसीटेटो, क्लोरिडो, इथिलीन डायमाइन, क्रोमेट, व्हाट थर्ड, सो सी हियर बेटा हाउ वी कैन ड्रॉ हियर फॉर्मुलेज, सो पे अटेंशन, इजी, डायमाइन, डायक्लोरिडो, प्लैटिनम, सेकेंड, सो एज यू नो हाउ वी आर राइटिंग, यस प्लैटिनम इज देयर, डायमाइन, क्लोरिडो फर्स्ट अमोनिया वी हैव टू राइट, यस, ओके, डायमाइन NH3 twice, dichlorido HCl2. So see here, diamine we give, Cl chlorido, dichlorido also we give. Now we have to check whether this second ion is coming or not. Means second oxidation number of this platinum is coming or not. So see. PtNH3 twice Cl2. So here X plus 0 plus on this chlorine, 1 chlorine minus 1, 2 chlorine minus 2 is equal to 0. So automatically X is equal to what? Plus 2. So then our structure is what? Correct. Understood. Now we will discuss pentamine, nitrito, O. Cobalt. So see here, cobalt, pentamine, okay, NH3 5, nitrito O means what? It is ambidentate ligand starting with joining with O, so their formula is like this, ONO. I hope you understood ONO here, and third, so see here how third you will get oxidation number when this cobalt here minus 1, no doubt your NO2 is always minus, NO3 is also a minus 1, no charge on this ammonia, so when, how much charge you have to give, then you will get cobalt as a plus 3, yes plus 2, then only you satisfy your cobalt third ion, okay, so our structure is correct. Now it's time to draw what? Sodium tetraacetato, chlorido, ethylene diamine, chromate, third. So as you know, sodium are there, so cationic part is there, chromate, HCr, tetraacetato. Tetraacetato means acetate, as you know, CH3COO, tetra means 4, chlorido, 1 only, and ethylene diamine is what, your EN. So how you will get charge on this third charge on this chromium? So for that, see here, when you will get, yes, you will get this as you know plus and this what minus. So on your Cl minus, okay, and when you will get third charge on this chromate, yes, very good, okay. Total you will get when you are writing in it as a 2, then only you will get, means see here plus 2 plus x, okay,
So total here 4 how much? Minus 4. Understood? Then your x becomes what? X becomes your plus 3. Means chromate charge is what here? Plus 3. Understood? So like that here, simple. Okay, you can cross check as this x plus 2. So see here, plus 2 plus x plus this 4 on each acetate, there is a minus 1. So this 4, 4 minus, and here 1 minus 1, that is minus 5 is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to what? Plus 3. Now your chromate become third. Therefore, now your completed whatever your this means from name also you have to draw the structure like that question they will come in theory also in your competitive also. Okay, so whatever we discuss, I hope you understood all. If any query, then you can share your query. So thank you very much and take care.